G'day. Designing roller coasters like this uses the mathematics of trigonometry. The cosine rule is one of the three trigonometry rules. Today, we will learn the three methods to use the cosine rule and great tricks to remember them. So why is the cosine rule useful? Well, the cosine of an angle is a mathematical operation that is the ratio of two sides of a right-angled triangle. That means that in any right-angled triangle, you only need to know two measurements, like the lengths of two sides or one angle in one side, and then if you use the rule, you can work out what all of the sides and all of the angles in the triangle are. Now let's see the cosine rule. In this right-angled triangle, here is the right angle. Opposite the right angle is the longest side called the hypotenuse. This angle here is marked with the Greek letter called theta. Opposite the theta angle is the side called the opposite side. Next to the theta angle is a side called the adjacent side. The rule is that the cosine of an angle marked theta equals the length of the adjacent side divided by the length of the hypotenuse. We usually shorten that to cos theta equals a divided by h. There are two more things to know before we do some examples. Notice that the cos rule has important measurements of the triangle close together around the angle. They are cosy around the corner like this. We also use a scientific calculator. There is a cos button on the calculator. It accesses all of the calculations for the theta angles that compare two sides. That's the adjacent side divided by the hypotenuse in right angle triangles. Now we're ready to see examples of how the cos rule is used. In this first example, we will calculate the horizontal length of this part of the roller coaster. It's the adjacent side that we mark with an X. The two sides that we already know are the size of this angle of 50 degrees and the length of this hypotenuse of 6 metres. Notice that all the important parts are cosy around the corner angle. Cos is cosy around the corner. The first step is to write the cos rule. Cos theta equals adjacent side divided by the hypotenuse. Next, substitute the numbers that we know. Angle theta is 50 degrees. The adjacent side is x because that's what we're trying to find. The hypotenuse is 6 metres. So cos 50 equals x divided by 6. Now we want to find the length of the adjacent side, that's x. Right now, x is divided by 6, so to get x by itself, multiply both sides of the equation by 6. That cancels out divide by 6 and leaves x by itself. We usually write the x on the left side and the working on the right side like this. So x equals cos 50 multiplied by 6. Now cos is a mathematical operation on an angle. Using the calculator, cos of the angle of 50 degrees is 0.6428. How we type into a calculator can vary from one calculator to another, so it's important to learn how your calculator works. So, x equals 0.6428 multiplied by 6. The answer is x equals 3.9 meters. That means in this part of the roller coaster, if the angle is 50 degrees and the slope length is 6 metres, the horizontal length of this part of the roller coaster is 3.9 metres. Here's a useful trick when you find the adjacent side using the cos rule. If x is on the top, you times in the next line. T for top, T for times. Let's see another example to find the adjacent side that we mark with an x. In this example, we will also let the calculator do a bit more work to save time. The two things that we already know are the size of the angle of 75 degrees and the length of this hypotenuse of 9 metres. The first step is to write the cos rule. Cos theta equals the adjacent side divided by the hypotenuse. Next, substitute the numbers that we know. Angle theta is 75 degrees. The adjacent side is x because that's what we're trying to find. The hypotenuse is 9 meters. Cos 75 equals x divided by 9. Now we want to find the length of the adjacent side, that's the x. Right now, x is divided by 9, so to get x by itself, multiply both sides of the equation by 9. That cancels out the divide by 9 and leaves x by itself. We write x on the left side and the working on the right side. So x equals cos 75 multiplied by 9. To save time, we'll do this in one step on the calculator. So cos 75 multiplied by 9 is the answer of 2.3 meters. That means in this part of the roller coaster, if the angle is 75 degrees and the slope length is 9 meters, the horizontal length of this part of the roller coaster is 2.3 meters. Here's a useful trick when x is on the top of the fraction. If x is on the top, you times in the next line. T for top, T for times. Now we will do an example to find the hypotenuse using the cos rule. Here, the hypotenuse is the length of the string up to the kite. We mark the hypotenuse with an x because that's what we're trying to find. The two things we already know are the size of this angle of 35 degrees and the length of this adjacent side of 8 meters. First, write the cos rule. Cos theta equals adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. Now substitute the numbers. Angle theta is 35 degrees, the adjacent side is 8 meters, and the hypotenuse is x. Notice that x is down on the bottom of the fraction. To get x by itself, we have two steps. Multiply both sides of the equation by x, and then divide both sides of the equation by cos 35. So x equals 8 divided by cos 35. Cos is a mathematical operation on an angle. Using the calculator, cos 35 is 0.8192. 8 divided by 0.8192 gives the answer of x equals 9.8 meters. The length of the string up to the kite is 9.8 meters long. Here's another trick to remember what to do when x is down on the bottom of the fraction. If x is down, you divide in the next line. D for down, D for divide. Let's do another example to find the hypotenuse using the cosine rule. We mark the hypotenuse with an x. The two things we already know are the size of this angle of 50 degrees and the length of this adjacent side of 9 meters. Here's the rule. Cos theta equals adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. Now substitute the numbers. Angle theta is 50 degrees, the adjacent side is 9 meters, and the hypotenuse is x. Notice that x is down on the bottom of the fraction. To get x by itself, we have two steps. Multiply both sides of the equation by x, and then divide both sides of the equation by cos 50. We simplify that, so x equals 9 divided by cos 50. Now use the scientific calculator in one step to get the answer that x equals 14 meters. The string up to the kite is 14 meters long. Remember the trick when x is down on the bottom of the fraction? If x is down, you divide in the next line. D for down, D for divide. For the third method of the cosine rule, we'll find the size of the angle of this ski slope. In this example, we already know that the adjacent side is 5 meters and the hypotenuse is 9 meters. The angle we are trying to find is marked with the Greek letter theta. Write the cos rule. Cos theta equals adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. The unknown angle we're trying to find is theta. The adjacent side is 5, the hypotenuse is 9. Now this example is a bit different to the previous examples, because this time we're working in reverse to find the angle. To tell the calculator that we're working in reverse, we press Shift before we press the cos button. The calculator will say cos to the negative 1. This means that we're working in reverse to find the angle. We type Shift cos open parentheses 5 divided by 9 close parentheses. The answer is 56.3 degrees. This ski slope has an angle of 56.3 degrees. Now for the third trick. If you want to find the angle, use Shift on the calculator. Let's do another example to find the angle of the ski slope. In this example, we already know the adjacent side is 6 metres and the hypotenuse is 8 metres. We are trying to find the angle theta. The rule is cos theta equals adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. The unknown angle we're trying to find is theta. The adjacent side is 6, the hypotenuse is 8. Now remember, we're working in reverse to find the angle. To tell the calculator we're working in reverse, we press Shift before pressing the cos button. The calculator will say cos to the negative 1. This means that we are working in reverse to find the angle. We type Shift cos open parentheses 6 divided by 8 close parentheses. The answer is 41.4 degrees. This ski slope has an angle of 41.4 degrees. Now let's summarise the main points of the cos rule. The cos rule is cos theta equals a divided by h. It's easy to spot a triangle where the cos rule will be used because the important parts of the cos rule are all cosy round the corner. In a question where x is on the top of the fraction, you times in the next line. T for top, T for times. In a question when x is down on the bottom of the fraction, you divide in the next line. D for down, D for divide. When you want to find the angle, you work in reverse by pressing Shift on the calculator. Thank you for watching this video.